So hello guys, today we will learn about applications of trigonometry. Now these are the things for which we learned the last chapter, for which we wanted to understand the last chapter, because we wanted to apply trigonometry. Before just starting this, I will go into what I taught in the previous lecture. Just to give a quick review, in the previous lecture I taught you two things: complementary angle properties and trigonometric identities. You need to learn these six things: sine 90 minus a is equal to cos a, cos 90 minus a is equal to sine a, tan 90 minus a is equal to cot a, cot 90 minus a is equal to tan a, sec 90 minus a is equal to cosec a, cosec 90 minus a is equal to sec a. These properties are important for solving questions like this. You can pause the video and review this question for a while. We also learned these three properties for trigonometry: sine square a plus cos square a is equal to 1, secant square a is equal to 1 plus tan square a, and cosecant square a is equal to 1 plus cot square a. Okay, so these were the things. We also solved this question. You can pause the video and read it once again, or watch my previous video to understand the question. Now we will move on to the next unit of this chapter. This is usually taught in class 10th CBSE board of India. This is the chapter 9th of NCERT, applications of trigonometry. I will start this topic. Let's suppose this is a tower. You know, we have towers. Like suppose this is a mobile tower. Its length is h, its height is h. This is a mobile tower whose height is h. Okay, suppose you are standing here. Okay, you are standing here. Let us name you Rick. Okay, suppose you are Rick and you are standing here. So the distance, so you can see the top of the tower and the bottom of the tower if you are standing here. Okay, you can see this. Now the angle which is formed between your viewing side of the bottom and top of the tower is called angle of elevation. Okay, and this length is called line of sight. We never usually look at the base of the tower. We usually tend to see the top of the tower. Therefore, this is called the line of the sight, not this. Okay, this is called the line of sight. Okay, what I told you, just there is a tower of height h. You are standing here. This distance, you can name it anything. Let's suppose name it x. Okay, the angle which is formed when you are looking at the top of the tower is called angle of elevation. Elevation because it is elevated. It is elevated. Otherwise, suppose this is you. Suppose this is you. Okay, you usually look in the front, but for top of the tower you need to elevate your eyesight. Therefore, this is called the angle of elevation. And the line of sight along which you look, the distance is called line of the sight. Okay, now consider another case. This is a tower and you are standing on the top of the tower. Okay, and here is your friend Morty. Okay, let's suppose name him M, you are Rick and he is Morty. Okay, R and M. Now suppose you want to look at your friend, what is he doing. This is your normal sight, okay, because you are standing on the top of the tower, but you need to look down to look on Morty. Okay, so this line is drawn. Okay, this is your viewing sight. So this is called the line of sight. The line along which you look is called line of sight. It is basically the distance between you and your object. Here this was you and this was you were looking at the top of the tower is called, therefore it is called the line of sight. Here you are at the top and you are looking at the bottom, therefore this is called the line of sight. This is your usual sight, but to look here you have to look downwards. Here you have to look upwards. You have to make your eye contact above. Here you have to shift your eyes downwards. Here you have to shift your viewing angle upwards. Therefore, this is called angle of elevation and this is called angle of depression. depression. Depression is going down, okay? So this is called angle of elevation, and this is called the distance between tower and the object. This is called the distance between tower and the object. Okay. You are looking down. The line along which you are looking is line of sight. The angle by which you have to change your viewing sight is called angle of depression or elevation, depending upon you are changing the sight upwards or downwards. Always remember that. Let me change my pen. Always remember that this is not the angle. This is the angle. This. Okay. This is not the angle. This is the angle. Okay. And this is the line of sight, not this. Okay. This is the height of the tower. This is the height of the tower. Okay. So we have studied two cases, one for angle of elevation and another for angle of depression. Now I will tell you how trigonometry is applied to solve these two cases. In these questions, you will let's suppose you will be given angle of elevation, height h, height of the tower. You have to calculate the distance between you and the tower. Okay, you can use trigonometry. You can use tan of this angle is equal to h upon x. Okay, if you are given the angle of depression, you can, if you are given this angle, you can calculate this angle. You can calculate this angle using 90 minus theta. Suppose this angle is A, this angle is 90 minus A. Now you can use trigonometry in this angle. You will be given height, you have to calculate X, or you will be given X, you have to calculate H, or you will be given line of sight. You will be given two variables, you have to calculate third. These type of questions are usually asked in problem for in these are not asked direct, these will be asked in statement question forms. Okay, so you have to do a lot of practice for these questions to hold a grip. These are very easy scoring questions. If you understand these questions, you will surely score good marks, at least in this unit. Okay, now I will discuss two questions, one of angle of elevation and one of angle of depression, to make you clear with the concept. So let's suppose this is the question. A tower stands vertically on the ground from a point on the ground which is 15 meter away from the foot of the tower. A tower stands vertically on the ground. So first we will draw what we know. Okay, let's suppose this is the tower. This is the tower. I'm not drawing in 3D, otherwise it will be difficult to understand. Let's suppose this is the tower. What if it has told us? A tower stands vertically on the ground. It is standing vertically. Vertically is this and horizontally is this. Okay. It's saying the tower stands vertically on the tower ground from a point on the ground. From a point on the ground. The statement of tower ends here. Okay. Now the next statement starts. From a point on the ground which is 15 meter away, which is 15 meter away from the foot of the tower, which is 15 meter away. Okay, so this distance is 15. The distance between the point mentioned here and the ground and the base of the tower is 15 meter away from the foot of the tower. The angle of elevation, the angle between this point and the top of the tower, this point and the top of the tower, angle of elevation is given. What is it is given? 60 degree. And you have to find the height. You have to find height h of the tower. So just as I told you, you are given the angle of elevation, the distance between these and these point, the distance of the tower is to be calculated. The height of the tower is to be calculated. How can you do it? You can do it using simple trigonometry. I hope you can solve this question yourself, but still I'm telling you solution. Okay, solution. Let's suppose tan 60. What is tan 60? Side opposite to angle 60, AB, divided by the remaining side. Let's name this point C. BC, okay, so is equal to, what is AB? AB is H and BC is 60, 15. BC is 15, so tan 60 is H by 15. Okay, what is the value of tan 60? Root 3 from the table I told you to learn is equal to H by 15. Therefore, H is equal to 15 root 3 meters. Always remember to write the unit in the final answer. Meters, because the question was given in meters. Okay, so this is the height of the tower. The question was very easy, but if you didn't know what is angle of elevation and you didn't know this concept, this will be a difficult question. So you need to understand this concept. You can rewind it if you didn't understand, and then come back again at the question so that you can understand it. Now I will discuss one question of this. So suppose this is the question. Consider a tower. We have to consider a tower. Okay. I will draw the tower here. Okay. Let's name this tower AB. Consider a tower of 30 meters. We are given its length. What is the length? 30 meters. Okay. You are standing on top of the tower. You are standing on the top of the tower. You are standing here. What is the distance of a point from you? Yahan se distance nikalna hai. We have to calculate the distance of a point from you. If its angle of depression, if we are talking about angle of depression, so the figure will be like this. So the figure will be like this. The angle of depression is 30 degree. So this angle is 30 degree. This must be the point. Let's name this point C. Okay, so this must be the point. Therefore, this is the figure we get. We have to calculate the distance of the point from you. We have to calculate the distance of the point C from you. Where are you? We are at A. Therefore, we have to calculate AC. AC is equal to, we have to calculate question mark. We are given AB is equal to 30 meters. Therefore, we will apply trigonometry in this triangle, but we don't know any angle. But we know this angle, therefore this angle will be 60 degree, because it is a right angle. Complementary angles, 30 and 60 are complementary. Okay, angle A is equal to 60 degree. We will use cos A. Cos A is equal to the remaining side AB divided by hypotenuse BAC. What is the value of AB? 30. What is the value of AC? We have to calculate. So we will leave it as it is. What is the value of cos A? Cos A is equal to cos 60 is equal to 1 by 2. Therefore, AC is equal to 60 meters. Now I have discussed two questions on this concept. Though these questions are more than enough for you to understand, but if you still have you will definitely need more practice, so you can go so I have mentioned a link in my description. You can solve some questions of that book, and if you have any doubts, post them in the comment section. And if you like my content and understood it, then please like my video, subscribe to my channel. Thanks.